everybody, it's time to play some quality mods for Doom 2. So our target in this video will be a mod called Doom 4. As you can see, it has 2-star rating, which is pretty good. So, as you can see, this mod, it consists of 32 levels, and they all are packed into 863 kilobytes of space. This mod was released on July 22nd in 2014, and it was created by 2 people. So we can see how people who played it rated it. So the ratings are varied. So the top ratings say that this map pack is Citizen Kane of Doom Wards. Somebody says that it's pretty cool, that it is the best ward in the history of Doom. Some rated really really high, say that 5 stars are not enough to rate the quality of this mod, and some people don't like it that much, say that it's not worth the download. Somebody says that it's only for love, that it's not a serious mod. So basically we'll play the mod and we'll see for ourselves how good it is. So the creators of this map pack say that it's designed for high level speedrunning. So they even showcase the times. For example, some levels can be completed in 10 seconds. Almost all of them can be completed in under a minute. Well, I personally won't speedrun it. I will try to 100% it. But judging from his times, it should be a quick map pack for me. So I have already played it before. I don't remember all of the levels, but there's unique music, there is unique title artwork. I will disable all of the music in the world because I don't know from where it's coming. For all I know, it could be copyrighted material, and I don't want my videos to go down. Basically, this mod only has one difficulty. So, if I remember correctly, some levels are on the harder side. So this is probably going to be a sort of a challenge for me. So first, I will show you the original title map of that mod. Will take some time, but it should be up very soon. So basically, here we go. As you can see, this is the original title map of the mod. Basically, as you can see, it appears that we are trying to showcase you the number 4, but apparently they weren't good enough to make a 4 in Romanic numbers. So what they did, they took the original 2 from a DooM 2 title and just copy-pasted it to make it look like 4. And as you can see, the colors are pretty funny. Doesn't look very great. But some people said that it is a masterpiece, that this VOD is very great. So we'll be able to see for ourselves if there's any quality for us to find here. So I don't plan to play this in vanilla. I will basically play this VOD with Project Brutality. I made some tests in advance, and it appears so far that I can play Project Brutality without much lag. But I basically set all the settings to the minimum, so if eventually we get into lag, then I guess it will be the end of this playthrough. Okay, so here we go. Project Brutality is underway. So we'll be soon ready to start our first map. Okay, it's taking some time, but eventually it will start. Okay, here we go. Seems that Project Brutality is up. Now it's time for me to play it. So I will be playing on standard difficult level, and I will be playing on dynamic progression, which means as more maps will be going on, the further the map, the harder the monsters on it. So here we go. Okay, so apparently the first time I tried to play this, the game volume was very high and I wasn't able to talk over it. So now I decreased the game volume back to 2%, so now I will be able to play this game and speak at the same time. So as you can see, the level design looks pretty original. Basically feels as if we are walking over toxic waste stairs. And there are not that many monsters here. And as you can see, some of them are stuck in place. This is not a very common team in this world, and basically in the most of the levels monsters act normally. So basically I will show how kicking works and also how quick melee works. As you can see, I can destroy those monsters very quickly. Oh, here we go. So all the monsters are now down and we are trying to run to the safety, but we will die eventually. So okay, now it's time for the second map. As you can see, there's already a Romero head hiding somewhere, but as far as I know, there will be no monsters spawned in here. There will be only the monsters which are placed in advance. It's okay. Time to get ready for the action, because from here onwards the levels will be getting much harder. So firstly, there are some monsters around here, and it seems like I'm going to die. As you can see, the difficulty level is already skyrocket. Okay, here we go. So apparently you can walk through this wall and it's necessary for the level advancement. And by the way, those zombies cannot pass the wall. So they are hiding behind it and they are trying to shoot me. So I will just try to shoot here and we'll drop a rocket. Just in case. Okay, here we go. So we dealt with the first room. And now it's time to advance onwards. Now there will be some surprises here. Basically there should be some arch vials behind this corner. So I will get rid of it really quickly. Okay, here we go. I'm not sure if I killed it. I killed it. But it's just the first arch vial. In total there should be 3 more of them. Okay, slowly getting rid of enemies, trying not to die in the process, and it seems like we are doing okay so far. Oh, we are baking another archway, but that's okay, we are going to deal with it. There we go. Okay, dealing just fine. So we have some extra health and extra shells around the corner. Oh, and the archvile is down. Now it's time for the final part of the level. And it will be 2 more archviles. So basically I'm pretty ready for it, I think. Okay, so here we go. Well, it's very important to not allow them to resurrect any more monsters. It would be pretty bad. Yeah, we already start the warp. Oh, but I'm not afraid of that. Okay, die, 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 die. Okay, it went down. And wait, that's new, I haven't seen it before. Okay, but just died. I don't even know how it came from where it came from. Okay, we dealt with it. And now it's time for the third level. The level is called the Gantland. And now we have plasma rifle with ourselves. And we'll try to use it to beat the level. But the issue with this level is that in the opening there should be around 4 arch vials in the starting room. So I will try to be quick. Real quick, because it's very easy to die here at the start. Okay, we dealt with the first 2 arch vials. Time for the third one. And for the fourth one. Okay, where are you? Here. So, okay, this room looks wonderful. If I'm not mistaken, yes. There is a missing texture right in here. So I can basically see right through it to the whole level. So I could use it to scout the room if I wanted to. Okay, another missing texture. So okay, time to open the door and check what's next. There should be a trap. Okay, here we go. Some more health and ammo. Time to get rid of more arachnotrons. So far it seems to be easy. But on this level it's usually important to check how much ammo do you have and if you're not running low on it. because if you run out of ammo, you basically have a loss. But it appears that on Project Brutality I should be able to finish the map with okay ammo. Because I tend to play squads with a lot of different mods. And on some of them ammo becomes an issue. But on Project Brutality it appears that ammo is not much of a problem. So we are clearing one room after the other. And we are doing it with ease. Okay, we'll take a short break right here.